Ooh, don't get too scared.
It's caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
It did the monster mash.
Hey everybody, this is 22 Tiger Dude, and I'm here to review the 2012 sequel, The Collection. And it is from the director of, guess what? The Collector, the 2009 original film. This film is about a man that escapes from the evil hands of a serial killer known as The Collector. But this man has been blackmailed into saving this innocent girl from a warehouse filled with gruesome, brutal booby traps. And that's really your basic plot for the overall movie. I didn't know this was a sequel, so with that being said, I have never seen the 2009 original film, The Collector. I came into this movie blind, and the only reason I saw this film is because it was instantly from Netflix. I was watching with my little bro and my cousin. You know, it's a horror slasher film, and I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. I thought it was shit. I did not like The Collection. I can understand why there's gonna be hate, but I can understand the people that say, hey, I enjoyed The Collection, but it's not my cup of tea. That's my own honest opinion. Let me go ahead and just start off with the positives. The serial killer, The Collector, despite the fact that he is one of those cliched slashers, I actually did think he was a cool character. I liked The Collector, a serial killer. As for the protagonist, I gotta say, Josh Stewart was really the only actor as a protagonist that I felt did a good job with the movie. This film is definitely a bloodbath, but I gotta honestly say that whenever there's a bloody moment that goes on, I actually liked it. The bloody moments in The Collection actually look realistic, and even though it may sound kind of sick and twisted, I actually enjoyed the bloody moments in the film. They were actually very well put together. And it actually has an awesome and very satisfying ending. And no, it's not because the film is over. Well, that's part of the reason. But it's just how the film ended that just felt really badass, and it kind of makes you cheer, fuck yeah. Now, let's get to my negatives. This movie is so stupid. The characters are generic. I just don't care about them. Any character that dies, I'm just all like, whatever. The girl that tags along with Josh Stewart, man, her acting is just absolutely terrible. She just plays a typical innocent girl. There wasn't anything special behind her, in my opinion. I just couldn't care for her. It was just hard to get into the rest of the characters as well, because the other actors, they were very cringe-worthy with their characters. The storyline was horribly written, it's not very well executed, and it doesn't make any fucking sense. The pacing is very rushed. There was really no build-up. The movie actually starts in like maybe the first 10 minutes. It took like 10 minutes for all this gore and everything's happening left and right, blah blah blah. Despite the fact that this movie actually does look good, I do like the cinematography behind this movie, I didn't think it was very well directed. I actually thought the direction for this movie was very sloppy. Cool shots, but how it was directed overall was just god awful. There was no reason to care for the characters. They're just there to be killed or whatever plot gimmick, and that's it, honestly. Like I said, I did enjoy the bloody and gory moments. Those were very well done. I thought the ending was badass. I actually cheered for the ending. The Collector was a cool character. Josh Stewart was a very cool protagonist. The movie looks good, but The Collection as a whole is crap. If I saw this movie back in 2012, it easily would have been on my worst list for one of the worst movies I've seen in 2012. It just wasn't my cup of tea, honestly. If you enjoy this movie, good for you. But this is my own honest opinion, and I'm gonna give The Collection 1.5 out of 4 stars. I'm glad I gave it a chance on Netflix Instant, but I just wish it was a movie that was a lot more better.